What's up, guys? In this tutorial, I will show you how to set up and optimize Discord on your Mac. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. First, to download and install Discord to your system, make sure to visit discord.com using your favorite browser. You're not required to log in with your account yet. Simply select to download the Discord installer for Mac when clicking on Download for Mac. It will take a minute or two to download the 150 MB installer to your system. Your browser can also help you find your downloaded files. On Chrome, simply click on the arrow icon next to the download and then select Show in Finder. Double-click the downloaded DMG file in your downloads folder. Next, drag and drop the Discord app into your applications folder to complete the installation. After installing Discord, launch the application and log into your account or create a new account if you don't already have one. In some cases, you will be required to enter the two-factor authentication code or scan the QR code to get access to your account. When all of this is done, you should be able to use Discord on your Mac. To get the most out of Discord, I suggest taking a quick look at your user settings. Click on the gear icon on the bottom of your screen to access your settings. In the Profile section, you can proceed to enter your user or server profile in case you have your own Discord server. Under Privacy and Safety, make sure that the Save Direct Messaging option is set to Keep Me Safe, which should be the default option. This will prevent users from sending you explicit or dangerous content. Next, in your app settings, you can choose to change the Discord appearance. This includes changing from light to dark theme or improving readability by changing the font size of your chat. You might want to exit your settings to make sure that your appearance settings are set to their best values. Next, in your voice and video settings, make sure that the correct audio input device, which is your microphone, and output device, such as your speakers or headphones, are selected. If you intend on using external speakers while chatting on Discord, then be aware that users might hear themselves in a voice channel. To prevent this from happening, you can use Push to Talk as your input mode instead of Voice Activity. This will improve the listening experience for other people in the call, and will also disable background noise when you're not talking. You can test your microphone below if you want to. In your advanced video settings, make sure that the echo cancellation option is enabled. Below, set the noise suppression option to standard if you experience normal background noise, such as your keyboard. If you have more than usual background noise, then set this option to crisp. When this is done, make sure to close your Discord settings and open up your System Preferences. You can do so by clicking on the Apple icon on the top left of your screen and selecting System Preferences. In your sound settings, make sure that the correct sound output and input device is selected again. This might have changed after installing and tweaking your Discord settings. On this window, you should also make sure that your sound device is not muted by unchecking the mute checkbox. In case some of these macOS or Discord options are not available to you, then make sure that you're running the latest software update. In your System Preferences, click on Software Update. Next, download the latest update in case there's one available to you before restarting your Mac. In case you have any further issues or problems following this tutorial, then I suggest following my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions and see you in the next one.